tacky bones. Hello there, malty merry seasonals. Ralphie here with Whisky Review 175. And I'm not clutching a glass of whisky, as you can see, I'm clutching a broom. There's a reason for that, malt mates. Oh yes, indeedy. It is an old Scots tradition that on the eve of the new year, you brush out the dust of the old year and have a clean hearth and a bright fire for the new year. And if you are ever first footing family in Scotland, you can observe the old tradition of taking a lump of coal. Have I got a lump of coal? No, it's burning. I'm not going to lift that out of the grate. You take a lump of coal and you hand it to your host in exchange for a large glass of whisky. Something like this, but larger. And what you're doing is you're giving fuel for the fire so that their hearth may be warm, because a warm hearth is a healthy diet, a healthy house, and it's fending off arthritis for another few years. It's another tradition simply because Scots were not allowed to celebrate Christmas for quite a while due to religious and political reasons, and business reasons. That the Scots celebrated New Year instead, which is why it's always been a sort of tradition. Although, if you're going to celebrate New Year in Scotland now, do it in a little cottage away from the crowds, because it's altogether over commercialised. I'm afraid so. You try getting a taxi in Scotland in the New Year's Day, you better have plenty of cash in your wallet. Ah, lovely. Here we are in the Manx traditional bothy. The fire is blazing in the hearth. Still a lot of condensation in the air. It's been going for hours. So we'll see what we can do in 2011 to dry this place out and make it more comfortable. But it's very traditional. I want to take this opportunity to thank Google, and thank Facebook, and thank YouTube staff and all the folk behind the scenes that keep these systems running, because having these facilities has enabled ordinary people anywhere in the world to approach a global audience. It's not just terrestrial television, newspapers and radio stations anymore that can reach out and exchange views, pass on information, give opinions. It's the internet really is changing an awful lot. And when you're using the internet, when you, the more you get into it, the more you see the opportunities and the potential in the future. And what's remarkable, most remarkable, is just how fast it's all happening. I want to take an opportunity of thanking all the folk that I've got to know over the last few years in the whisky industry. And if I may make a comment, and hopefully this will reach the ears of the big bosses in the big whisky companies and the little whisky companies. Guys, you're doing a damn good job. You certainly put a shift and a half in at the whisky shows in chasing up business and making contacts and in selling whisky all around the world. It's a lot of air miles. It's not a job I fancy doing myself, but I certainly have a great appreciation the more I get to know the people who have made the whisky industry their careers. By the way, Scotland, even at this stage, has absolutely no idea just how much Scotland needs Scotch whisky. And I would like to think that there is a greater collective national appreciation in Scotland for a national beverage, but the Scots do have a habit of not appreciating what's on their own doorstep, and that's a fact. I would also like to thank you, yes you, I know you're watching, because I really appreciate the growing audience from all the different places around the world, America and Europe and Canada. All you Canadians, big thumbs up to you. Scandinavia, India, from places that I wouldn't really expect, from Pakistan and China, all you Chinese students studying your English, I hope that my clear accented English is helpful in your studies. To all the folk in Russia, good luck with your age-matured vodkas and such like. It's interesting to see just how international not just whisky is becoming, but spirits. People are now thinking about new ways of putting new flavours into new spirits, and it's a very interesting times. And it's with that in mind that I conclude this little end of year vlog by introducing my whisky of the year. Just poke the fire a wee bit. There we go. Nice roaring fire. With the amount of whiskies that I have, it had to be a good one. The amount of whiskies that I buy, not just getting tasting from tasting bottles, but you know, going through bottles and seeing how the whiskey changes in the bottles, which is something I'll cover later. But here it is. Boonahabin 12-year-old. And Boonahabin is my whisky of the year because this is £31.90 a bottle when I bought it. Simple packaging. Practical, sensible bottle with a label that says 46.3%, natural colour and unchill filtered. Two reasons why this makes a single malt better and makes quite a number of blends better is at the end of the day, when we're past all the marketing, malt whisky and quite a few blends are about two things, and two things alone. The intrinsic quality of smell and the intrinsic quality of taste. All the ice, all the tumblers, the cocktails, and all the rest of it are for basic blends. Single malts are very special because they have such an incredible smell and such an incredible taste. And that is enhanced when you bottle at a higher alcoholic strength. You don't chill filter it, so you keep the mouth feeling. You don't add colour, so you don't basically make it more artificial. It's about keeping it natural, because that's the way it is best. And once you've done this, you can charge a bit more because people will pay. But whisky industry, listen up. Don't come out with stupid whisky prices that are way over the top, because you'll sell a few bottles, but you'll start to lose a big reputation in the process. When making decisions about bottling and presenting whisky to the market, make sure the people who know the job producing the whisky are involved and always give them the budget to buy good wood, invest in good casks, and invest in proper storage and management of stocks. There we go. And that is why Boonahabin is my whisky of the year. A big thumbs up to Burn Stewart, the owners of this distillery, and also of Tobermory and Deanston, for grabbing the bull by the horns, figuratively speaking, and responding to the way the single malt whisky market is going. It's a lovely whisky, one of the softest but quite complex of the Islay distilleries. In its old presentation, it was a delicious whisky. In its new presentation, delicious, just got a bit more tasty. Superb whisky. Thoroughly enjoyed it. It's out there. It's available. Look out for it, malt mates. It's Ralphie recommended. So your good health. Here's to 2011, whether you be celebrating a Western New Year or a Chinese New Year or whatever time your New Year is. Your good health, and remember to sweep out your floor and open the door for a piece of coal from your first visitor. And if they've forgotten to bring it, just send them away to find a piece. Mind you, any fuel will do. See you soon.